As I mentioned at the end of my previous video on my direct granules extruder project, I had begun conducting further print tests. With a more solid gearbox, the development work on the mechanics should actually be almost complete. But as so often in life, physics doesn't follow the laws of wishful thinking. The gearbox became increasingly louder after printing less than 2 kg of PLA, indicating wear. The bench you see here is particularly bad in the bottom layers due to me experimenting with the parameters during printing. Depending on the print speed and material throughput, the extruder gets really loud when the gears start to vibrate resonantly, as can be heard here on the chimney. A major problem is that the gearbox is subjected to a relatively high axial force, which this component is not designed for. The auger screw presses against the type 6900 ball bearing with an outer diameter of 22 mm. Such ball bearings can absorb high radial forces, but only significantly smaller axial forces. A second problem is that the auger screw, which is directly bolted on the output shaft, also experiences forces perpendicular to the extruder axis. Due to the long lever, the axial force component is amplified. Furthermore, the force acting on the gears is close to the specified maximum torque in the event of a clogged nozzle and thus a blocked output shaft. All of this leads to forces acting inside the planetary gearbox that the gears are obviously not designed to withstand. However, the wear isn't really visible, the gears don't look bad and the gearbox still works reliably, if you ignore the increased noise level. My first idea was to simply omit the gearbox and have the extruder screw driven directly by a high torque motor. The strongest NEMA 17 stepper motor in my stock delivers a holding torque of 60 Nm. The printing worked in principle, but firstly, only with a relatively low material throughput, and secondly, the retraction could only be carried out very slowly, which led to significant stringing. The results weren't really any better with my other NEMA 17 stepper motors. Only the NEMA 23 series models offer significantly higher torque, but they are also significantly heavier and much larger. So a new gearbox was needed. I decided to print my own gearbox from PETG. By cleverly choosing the design parameters, this can better absorb the specific forces acting on the gears. The central element on which the forces act is the ball bearing. Standard ball bearings are primarily designed for forces in the radial direction. However, there are so-called thrust bearings that are designed for forces in the axial direction. It should be noted that not only an upward force acts on the bearing during extrusion, but also a downward force during retraction. This would require 2 thrust bearings or at least 1 special bearing with 2 integrated bearings of this type. However, I prefer to use standard parts, so I'm using an inexpensive radial bearing type 6001 with 28 mm outer diameter. Time will tell if this is sufficiently sturdy. What other design parameters will hopefully ensure a long service life of the plastic gear? Well, since plastic is less stiff and abrasion resistant than well lubricated steel gears, I designed the teeth significantly wider at 15 mm. The tolerances of my printed gears are larger than those of their industrially manufactured steel counterparts. Therefore, even when new, there is a noticeable radial backlash. Since permanently a radial force acts on the shaft during extrusion, the teeth of the 2 gears are pressed tightly against each other and with that, the backlash doesn't matter that much. As mentioned, the ball bearing doesn't absorb the forces from the extruder ideally. As long as the forwarded movements through the ball bearing are smaller than the backlash of the gears, This doesn't lead to increased wear, as was obviously the case with the tight tolerance steel gears. The slight backlash and the fact that this isn't a planetary gear are advantageous. With a homemade gear from a 3D printer, you can also freely choose the reduction ratio. As the experiments with the direct drive have shown, a reduction ratio smaller than 5:1 should be sufficient. The outer ring has 32 teeth, the pinion has 11 teeth, resulting in a reduction ratio of 2.91:1. The smaller reduction allows for a faster retraction and reduces the force acting on the gears when the output shaft is blocked. In the first version, the output shaft was made of a centrally drilled M12 brass screw. However, the print quality achieved with this rigid coupling were not particularly good. The current version also comes from the 3D printer and is reinforced with 3mm screws, as a purely plastic shaft with a diameter of 12mm would not be able to withstand the resulting torque. The coupling between the gear and the extruder screw is flexible. As with some of my early prototypes, an M8 nut is soldered to the screw which fits into a slightly larger hexagon hole on the gear shaft. The screw head is rounded with a file. This gives the screw an additional degree of freedom in its movement which reduces the force acting on the ball bearing. The printed gearbox is barely larger than the metal counterpart and in terms of weight there is a difference of 121 grams in favor of the plastic version. I deliberately did not lubricate the gears to see where wear will occur over time. Initial tests show good print quality, although the printing parameters could not yet be optimized due to my dwindling raw material supply. Shown here is my standard test, the small track link. I will show how the PETG gearbox performs in terms of durability in an upcoming video. First I need to upgrade my spark erosion machine to produce a more sturdy sieve for my powder mill and then resume production of more raw material for my extruder. I'm currently working on several aspects of the project simultaneously. If you'd like to support me in my efforts to develop this new type of FDM printing free from patents, on my website, besides the build instructions for this gearbox and the corresponding extruder, you can also find a donate button. Many thanks to my anonymous major sponsor and to all the other wonderful people who have already given me a financial boost in one way or another. Thanks for watching and I'll be back.